Today we're going to run through one of the tools that we're using for one of our monitoring projects, which is the Victorian Environmental Flow Monitoring and Assessment Program. One of the major objectives of the VEFMAP program is looking at the response of fish to flows, and one of the tools we're using to do that is using ear bones, also called otoliths. We're going to run through what otoliths are, how to extract them out of a fish, how we prepare them, and the sort of information that we can get out of otoliths.
Typically, this is what a fish that an angler brings back from a day's fishing will look like. It's normally been gutted and its gills removed. We end up with a specimen like this. At the base of the skull here, we can see a small capsule, the otoliths capsule. On a small fish like this, which is a lot smaller than what anglers will be keeping, it's actually quite clear, and you can see the otoliths sitting inside that clear capsule. So what we're going to do is crack the base of that capsule, lift it up like a hatch, and then pull the otoliths out. Drop them onto a bit of paper towel and blot them dry. Once they're fairly dry, we'll store them into the paper envelopes, the front of which has got the details of the size of the fish, the location and date of capture, and that's it.
So when otoliths are brought back here to the lab, we need to what we call section them so we can get all our measurements out of them. So for otoliths this size, we take what's called a transverse section, so I'll cut across it. To do that, we mount the otolith in resin. It sets hard, and then we take a cut using this Gemmaster saw, and we take a transverse section that's less than a tenth of a millimetre. So once the sections have been cut, we glue them onto a microscope slide and then look at them under a microscope. For a little bone in a fish, we can get an amazing amount of information. If I zoom in, we can see each of the rings. And this is basically how we age our fish. Count the number of rings, and that's how old the fish is. So not only can we get the age of the fish, each of these rings, just like rings on a tree ring, has a specific width, and that actually tells us how much a fish has grown in that particular year. When a fish lays down each of these rings, it lays down information about the chemistry or the water chemistry of the site it was living in. So we can actually tell where a fish has been and if it's moved between different regions. And by looking at the year that those chemistry signatures change, we can actually tell when a fish moved between regions. So it's quite amazing. The chemical signature at the core of the otoliths as well, we can actually work out where a fish was born, and not only where it was born, but whether it was produced in a hatchery or whether it was spawned naturally in the wild. We're doing a lot of independent monitoring. We also recognise that anglers are out there catching fish themselves on some of our northern Victorian rivers, and they're out there catching Murray cod and golden perch, and we can get some great information out of that.